Hi friends, so welcome again to this problem solving session and continuing with our topic on nature of roots of a quadratic equation. We have taken one problem over here and the problem says find the value of k for which the equation has real and equal roots. Guys, real and equal roots. The moment we see this, first thing we should come in our mind is the value of d. So what do we know about nature of roots? For you know, the condition for nature of roots to be real and equal, we know that discriminant must be 0, and discriminant is nothing but b square minus 4ac, where b is the coefficient of x, a is the coefficient of x square, and c is constant term, right? So b is coefficient of x and a is coefficient of x squared and c is constant term. So if we know that, so for roots of a quadratic equation, for roots of a quadratic equation to be equal, we must have to be equal, and obviously real and equal. So I've forgotten this, real and equal. We must have d must be equal to 0, right? That is b square minus 4ac must be equal to 0. Now let us deploy the values over here. So if you notice carefully, b is 3k here, c is 4, and clearly a is 9. So the task is very simple. Now deploy the values. So hence 3k whole square is b square minus 4 times a, 9 times c, that is 4, is equal to 0. So if I simplify this, what will I get? I'll get 9k square, clearly, and this is nothing but minus 9 times 16 is 0, isn't it? So this implies, if you see 9 can be cancelled out, isn't it? 9 is common from both, so hence it can be cancelled. Or you can say dividing the entire equation by 9, you'll get k square minus 16 is 0, or k square is equal to 16, or k is equal to plus minus root 16, right? Which is nothing but plus minus 4. So k could be either 4 or k is equal to minus 4. In both these cases, there will be two cases, that is k equals to 4 and k equals to minus 4. In both the cases, roots will be roots of which equation? The given equation. The given equation was 9x square plus 3kx plus 4 equals to 0 are real and equal. Okay, this is what is the solution to this question. Let us take another question. So if you see, we have to find the value of k for which the given equation has real and equal roots. So by now you all of you know that, you know, for real and equal roots, what is the criteria is for, let me write this, for real and equal roots. For real and equal roots of a quadratic equation, we must have d, which is nothing but b square minus 4ac, must be equal to 0. So this is the criteria for the real roots, you know it. Okay, so what are a, b and c in this case? If you clearly see, a is 1, right? 1 times x square it is, right? What is b, guys? B is minus 2, 1 plus 3k. So anything which is associated with the variable x is b, and now c is 7 times 3 plus 2k, isn't it, which is nothing but 21 plus 14k, right? 21 plus 14k. Now let's, you know, complete the solution. So let's find d is how much? B square. So b is minus 2, 1 plus 3k, and this is whole square, and minus 4 times a is 1, and c is 21 plus 14k, isn't it, right? And this must be 0. So hence it is 4 times 1 plus 3k whole square minus 4 times 21 plus 14k must be equal to 0. So clearly this 4 is common to both, so hence 4 can be eliminated, right? You can divide the entire equation by 4 and you will get, you know, the 4, this particular 4 gets eliminated. Now you open the brackets, you will see this is nothing but 1 plus 2 times 1 times 3k plus 3k whole square, isn't it? A plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square, and this is minus 21 and this is minus 14k is equal to 0, right? So minus 1 times 21 minus 21 and minus 1 times 14k is minus 14k here, right? So let's simplify further. It is 1 plus 6k and this is 9k square. So 3k whole square is 9k square. Many people make mistakes while doing these simple, you know, mathematical manipulation. So please be very, very cautious and careful. So minus 21 minus 14k. Many people I have seen, they will do 3k square is 3k, right? 3k whole square, they will write 3k square, and here is where you get it wrong. So be careful. This is equal to 0. Now, what? Let's, arrange them in an order. So 9k square comes first. 6k minus 14k is minus 8k. Okay, and 1 minus 21 is minus 20. This is equal to 0. Correct. So what is it? We get another quadratic equation in k. So let us solve it by splitting the middle term. So clearly it is 9 times minus 20. AC is 9 times minus 20, which is minus 180, guys. So what is to be done? So clearly 18 times 10, so minus 80 is also minus 18 times 10. So, and why am I doing this? Because minus 18 plus 10 will be minus 8. That's what is the middle term splitting process, right? So hence I can now write 9k square minus 8k can be written as minus 18k plus 10k. And why did I do this? Because 18 times 10 gives me 180, which was also equal to 9 times 20. So hence it will help me in factorization. This is a method for factorization. So what can I do for the first two terms? Separate 9k, take it common. Then what is left? K. And what is left here? 2. Then what is the process? Just simply write k minus 2 and then complete it by writing 10 here, because 10k will give you 10k here. And 10 times minus 2 will give you minus 20 here. So this becomes easier for me. So hence, this implies k minus 2 is a common factor. And it is 9k plus 10, isn't it? This is equal to 0. So our job is done, right? So what will this be? Solution will be either k minus 2 is 0 or 9k plus 10 is equal to 0. Isn't it? So what will be the values like? So the values will be the values will be k is equal to 2 or k is equal to minus 10 upon 9. Okay, so hence there are two values for k equals to 2 or k equals to 2 or k equals minus 10 upon 9. If this is so, then the given quadratic equation will have real and equal roots, right? So this quadratic equation will have real and equal roots. Okay, this is how you have to solve it. So what did we do in this question? We simply applied the condition, discriminant must be equal to 0. Put the values of a, b, and c. In a, b, and c, there will be unknown k. And with this condition, d is equal to 0, we figured out what is the value of k. And it came out to be k equals to 2 and k equals to minus 10 upon 9. Right? This is how you have to solve these kind of questions.